Have you ever wanted to automatically add timestamps or timecodes to any transcript for free? It is now possible to do that. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, and in this video, I will show you how to automatically add timestamps to any transcript that you have without the need to press any hotkeys or anything. Normally, in ExpressScribe, you have to configure the hotkeys that you want to use. But for this method, we'll use an application that was released this year called Descript, and I'll use the Descript for Windows version. For this to work, you need three things. You need Descript for Windows, and at any time during this video, you can check the show notes for the links and my referral link so that you can get 100 free minutes of automatic transcription from the service. Now, what you need Descript for Windows or for Mac or for the web interface. Number two, you need your transcript that has been prepared, whether by a human or just automated from YouTube or any other application. And number three, you need the original audio file that was transcribed for that particular project. So what I'll do is just I'll fire up my Descript and let it be opening up in the background. And then I'll just take you to the quick write-up of the update. And this update was sometime in August. And you can import a transcript. And you can use on Descript, whether it's human transcription service that prepared that transcript or an automatic video, YouTube video transcription. You just load the audio and the text, and Descript will sync them up word by word. They actually even autocorrect the speaker labels and tags. So basically, you need a couple of those things. And if you heard me right during the first section, is that this is completely free. You're probably wondering, why is it important to add timestamps? Clients may require you to add a timestamp after every 1 minute. Now, sometimes it's really tiresome to do this on an application like this, on ExpressScribe or any other transcription software that you're using. And it gets quite hectic doing all this. But for this process to work, all you need are those three things: your audio, transcript, and Descript. Now, my Descript is running, so I'll just open it up for us all to follow along as I do this process, because it's an easy and time-saving process. Now, if I jump on to something else, is that I'll show you this job sample on Upwork. Transcribe a 22-minute or Spanish audio directly into Spanish text. No translation needed in 2 days. This was posted 2 days ago. And if I hover over it, it was posted on November 5th. Now, if you look at the job description, I need you to transcribe what you hear in the Spanish audio directly into Spanish text and put timestamps every 10 seconds. Now, if somebody told you to put timestamps every 10 seconds using ExpressScribe or any other software that you're using, that gets quite cumbersome and gets in the way of you transcribing. So I'd recommend you just focus on the transcription process and then let Descript do its thing. So what we're going to do is that I'm going to come to my Descript. It's already open now. And I'll click on Add New. When I click on Add New, I'll navigate to the folder that has my audio file that I want to have automatic timestamps added. And it's this audio on how to easily download YouTube subtitles as transcripts. And the pop-up that will follow from a Descript is that they suggest whether I want to do an automatic transcript or whether I want to use their white glove transcription service, which is human-powered. And their charges are $1.25 per minute of audio. And this audio is about 2 minutes, 40 seconds, so it comes to about $3.75. Or I want to import a transcript. So this is free, and please note it's free to do this. To import a transcript is free. So I believe even if your minutes are over or if your subscription is over, you can still import this for free. So I'll just click on next, and I have my transcript open. Just copy it, Control C. Just come back and Control V, and I paste it. Once I do this, all I need to do is just hit on sync, and my audio will start uploading, that's initializing, and then it's going to upload my audio file onto the Descript servers. And as it uploads the file, it's 100% done. The next step that we follow is that we'll get to the syncing part of the text to the audio. So the audio that just uploaded is going to be synced to the text that I just pasted. Now, this may take some time, really depends on the length of your audio file or sometimes the connection that is available. My audio has already loaded on the platform, so you can play and pause and do any other edits that you want. We are now waiting for the syncing of the text of the audio. So you can do this, go get a coffee or something as you wait for this to be done. And it doesn't take long. Really depends on the length of the audio or the video file that you're working with and what needs to be done. You know, sometimes all this artificial intelligence needs to understand what is going on to get a couple of words so that it can append everything as it should be. My text is done syncing, and if I play it for you.
Hello and welcome to another easy to follow tutorial on how to download.
I believe it has synced correctly, and you can see the timestamps here, but this is not the desired result that we are looking for. Now that we have everything loaded, what you need to do is you need to navigate to the share icon and click on it. And you may either decide to get a private link for this project, and you can invite other people to edit or do anything to the file, but we need to export. The export option, we have the document, subtitles, and the audio file. For this, we just need to export the document file. And for the document file, we have the option to include timestamps. So remember the job I just showed you on Upwork, where the client required 10-second interval timestamps? Then if that's what we desired, all we need to do is just crank this down or just type in 10 seconds. Every 10 seconds, we're going to get the timestamps applied. You can also apply paragraph breaks or speaker labels or markers. For this video, I'm going to show you just how to add the timestamps at around 10-second intervals. My audio is 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So all I need to do is select the time intervals that I need. And for this, I'll just go with 30 seconds. Let me just place 30 seconds. And the options available at the moment for to export are in Microsoft Word. Just select that and hit on export. Now, once I hit export, you'll get a notification on the bottom left where the export is completed. So I'll just click on open. And it will navigate to the folder that is flickering at the bottom, the downloads folder. And if I click on it, you'll see my transcript is already there. So I'll just double click on it and navigate. Now the timestamps start at the first minute, that is at the base 000, 0 hours, 0 minutes, 0 seconds. And at the 30th second, we get another timestamp or time code, depending on what you want. At 1 minute, we get some. At 1:30, at 2 minutes, and at 2:30. Now, basically, it's that easy. All you need to do is just upload your audio file to Descript, import the transcript, and wait for the syncing of the audio to the text or the syncing of the text to the audio to complete, and just share your file and export it with your desired timestamp intervals. I hope that you've learned something and that you'll spend more time transcribing your audio files into clean transcripts that clients will love and owe them using the timestamps and all those kinds of things. So areas that this is applicable is when you find a client that has transcripts and all they need is timestamps. You don't have to go in manually and start doing it manually. You can just cruise through using Descript and apply the necessary timestamp intervals that are required or time codes, and then just send them the file in a record time so you can make more money and you can spend less time doing the work that gets in the way of transcription. Thank you so much for watching this video, and until next time, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and feel free to comment with any requests that you have for me to shoot for a later date. Thank you and have a good time.